Vukovar, the first city that got attacked by the Serbs during the war in 1991. In 2014, both ethnic groups are still fighting about the narrative of this conflict. History teacher Dino Rados tries to put his emotions aside when he's talking about it, which is apparently not easy.
Just a few meters away, there are some Serbian cafes. And only Serbians go there, not Croatians. That's the problem here with the Serbs. When I say they, I don't mean every Serb, but they keep shouting, this is Serbia, Vukovar is Serbia. And that is how it comes to the fight between Croatians and the Serbians. Some Serbs didn't accept this country as their own. They still think it's a part of greater Serbia or something like that. I think there will never be a coexistence between us and the Serbs. If it stays like this, we should educate today's young generation not to hate, but it's like I said, they have their parents, and parents teach them to hate other nation. Serbian parents teach hate Croatian kids, and in the other way, Croatian parents teach their kids to hate Serbian kids. Hatred did that 23 years ago, and I'm afraid that if it continues like this, it will bring to the war again. Maybe not war, but the more separation between Croatian and Serbs. The hanging, you know, the Croatian teachers hang out with the Croatian teachers, and the Serbian teachers hang out with each other. When their shift ends and our begins, that's it. You know, no more hellos, no more talking. It reflects on the kids. They see that, and it reflects on the kids. Yes, I know we should be our role models in that, but it's, like I said, it's so hard. We got our own history, they have their own. It's very hard to change that. What if the Croats and Serbs would go together, starting from kindergarten, with the attitudes they get it from home? How would that look like? You would put them together with that attitudes. I hate Serbs, I hate Croatians. And how would that look like? We have to clear that first. No hatred, full coexistence with the love, with respecting each other. That's the first step we should do. The next would be putting together the kids, starting from kindergarten, putting them together, Croats and Serbs. And that would be the second step. That's it.
It sounds easier than it is. A group of Croatian war veterans called Štozar made the news recently after they tore down Cyrillic signs of public buildings. The signs are in Serbian language due to state regulations, but the symbol for coexistence end up in a symbolic aggression.
And there should be, you see, it's taken away, you see? You see that empty place? Vratite latinicu I bit će sve u redu. It means bring back the Latin and everything will be just fine. And so the Cyrillic and Latin table were here, but it was taken away. I don't know by whom, but you can assume it's from Stožer. And so is right over there, in that institution. It's also taken away. The same things, it's written right here. It's written right here. Bring the Latin and everything will be all right. Vratite latinicu I bit će sve u redu.
When even teachers like Dino can't let go of the past, the next generation will also face separation, leaving a city that can't grow together.